In our previous video, we discussed the four-way tool post. We proposed a system to efficiently measure the required shim thickness to bring a tool to centre height. In this video, we'll show you how to go about making this dial. We start by mounting a blank disc to a superglue arbor. The rotary table is mounted to the milling machine to form the outside of the dial. This is required to form a small tab, which locates with the DTI to establish its orientation. The tab is cleaned up using needle files. A dividing head is mounted onto the lathe to form the divisions. This begins with the insertion of an expanding plug into the back of the spindle bore. The dividing head is then slotted onto the back of this mandrel. A plate is then slotted onto one of the change wheel arbors. This constrains the dividing head rotationally. To engrave the divisions, all you need is a V-tool mounted on its side in the tool post. To remove the burrs brought up from the engraving process, just knock them off with the tool. Marking the numbers is ultimately dependent on what tools you have available. Here we use a gravograph pantograph machine. Stamps or punches will also suffice. A small amount of heat breaks the superglue bond. In this process, we dish the dial. To make the numbers and divisions more readable, we use a marker pen. You can also use engraver's wax or paint. All that's left to do now is assemble the DTI with the new dial. Because this new dial is numbered in reverse, it allows the shim thickness to be read directly. Of course, the same manufacturing process can be applied for other kinds of dials, such as watch dials. Here we use aluminium due to the low cost, and as it is a workshop tool, it doesn't need to be fancy. If, however, you were making a watch for instance, you would probably want to choose a different material, such as silver. If you're interested in taking dial making to the next stage, I'd encourage you to look into galouche, which is an advanced embellishment technique commonly used in watchmaking. Clickspring does some excellent videos explaining this process. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any further suggestions, please do put it in the comments below. We do make every effort to read them. And we would hugely appreciate it if you considered subscribing to our channel for more content in engineering and machining.